Been a busy Monday. Good evening, everybody. The Arkansas media relations staff working overtime today for its basketball program. A lot to cover, so let's begin with confirmation that assistant coach Isaac Brown has been reassigned. So he remains with the university, but a search underway to find a replacement on the bench. And despite speculation, veteran coach Rob Evans will be returning to John Pelfrey's staff. And so is longtime assistant Tom Ostrom. That is according to a press release issued by Arkansas that also included numerous quotes from Pelfrey and AD Jeff Long on the state of the program. Now, in today's release, Pelfrey's record is compared to that of predecessors Stan Heath and Nolan Richardson even. Local media then received a two-page email with tons of interesting notes and stats about Pelfrey's accomplishments and his players the last few seasons. So here is a look at the overall numbers. The 20-win season when he first arrived, a senior-led class that went to the second round of the NCAA tournament, and the last 2 years, which include sub-500 records overall and in league play. And also noticeable are the ugly stretches to end those seasons with no postseason appearances of any kind. So that got us thinking here at 4029. How does John Pelfrey's efforts, 51-46 in 3 years, compare to some other coaches in their first 3 years on the job? And by that, inheriting a struggling program. Here are a few examples. The first, up north at Missouri, Mike Anderson took over the Tigers program following the Quinn Snyder catastrophe and has posted 65 wins and in his third year a trip to the Elite Eight along with 31 victories. Mizzou is back in the big dance this year. Now let's move southwest. Rick Barnes took over after a scandal involving Tom Penders. First 3 years, Barnes won 68 games and went to the NCAA tourney each time. And our emotional, sweaty friend in Knoxville, Bruce Pearl, inherited a sub-500 Vol team from Buzz Peterson. First 3 years, 77 wins and a couple trips to the Sweet 16. Now, another source of intrigue surrounds Pelfrey's roster. There's been various players departing the last couple of years, and reports had surfaced Rotnei Clarke was pondering it as well. The sophomore shooting guard was second on the team in scoring and their best three-point threat. He's been a popular player with the fans, and his record-setting 51-point game earlier this season helped fuel that as well. Now, the U of A releasing this tonight just moments ago, quoting Rotnei, contrary to a local television station report over the weekend that I was seriously considering transferring, I wanted to make it clear to the Razorback fans that I will return to play basketball for the University of Arkansas next season. It has never been my intention to transfer. I am looking forward to working with Coach Pelfrey and the rest of my teammates this offseason to improve individually as well as a team for next year, end quote. Interesting stuff. Finally, how about some trouble for Cliff Lee today? Pitching against the Diamondbacks, puts one right over the head of Chris Butler. Butler doesn't like it. Bench is clear. The former Hog ejected. Lee says it wasn't intentional, and it's spring training. We'll all get over that. But obviously the big story here tonight is Arkansas basketball. A lot happening today, and the news just coming out. Rotnei Clarke not going anywhere, so at least one player is returning.
Going to stay put. A lot of the fans have been saying give Pelfrey one more year and see what happens.
Looks like that's going
to
happen as well.
And Rotnei Clarke's story, that, just to make it clear, that was not us that reported.
That
you didn't report
us.
That.
No, we did not.
Okay, good.